Today, we're purely working on the top-down draw cut. Twist the sayar up, pull the sword out upwards dash. Motion the sword in an arc and one-handed diagonal cut. Let's not forget the sayabiki to go as far as physically possible. A slightly different target, the aim is a kesa to the face. There was a lack of tenuchi there, resulted in lack of target intent. In other words, the cut was not strong or sharp when cutting the face. Good thing I noticed this during the session. To illustrate, the kasaki needs to dot have a sharp casting effect speed to the target. Tip needs to accelerate towards the target. This comes with tenuchi control. At least this is what I believe it should look like. A quick epiphany. I believe the Seiti Kada dot Sampogiri has an answer on the first cut. Big arch or small and compact? Leave your comment below of your preferred style. Back to the big kesa target. With the same context, I want to achieve that acceleration from entry to exit of target. Combining both elbow leverage for the big arch and the tenuchi for the acceleration on the target. Let's slow it down and break it down a little. Looking at it again, perhaps I squeezed tenuchi too early. This is a matter of muscle memory and awareness. It's going to take a lot of practice to do this naturally. Something to take note for sure. Changing some minor perspective. Target to the face. Now that is an embarrassing footwork. Wonder why I do that. Probably how I was aiming for reach. Seemed I changed my footwork going back. Big kesa cut. Or perhaps I was aiming for stability with my back leg. Either way, I need to practice more. Good to see I haven't forgotten sayabiki. Next, let's go back to face cuts. Weird, pretty sure I was on target dashed. Maybe it's a camera angle. Last round to conclude the video for today. Looks fair enough that I hope you enjoy today's brief session. Thanks. I'll see you in the next one.